myself Vedangini. I'm a legal intern at Lexis & Company. And my today's topic for the discussion is the grounds of divorce under Hindu Marriage Act. So let's begin. So basically, in ancient times, the concept of divorce was not known to anyone, and everyone considered marriage as a sacred concept. According to Manu, the husband and wife cannot be separated from each other, and their marital tie cannot be broken. So later than after that, the concept of divorce came into picture and established as a custom to put an end to the marriage. And according to Arthashastra, marriage can end even if it is dissolved by mutual consent and should be an approved marriage. But Manu does not believe in the concept of the dissolution, and the only way to end the marriage is the death of one of the spouses, according to Manu. So the provision related to the concept of divorce was introduced by the Hindu Marriage Act 1955, and the Hindu Marriage Act defines divorce as a dissolution of the marriage. And for the interest of the society, the marriage or the marital relationship needs to be surrounded by every safeguard for the cause specified by law, and divorce is permitted only for a grave reason otherwise given other alternative. Now let's discuss what is divorce under the Hindu Marriage Act 1955. So in the Hindu Marriage Act, there are some provisions given regarding a valid divorce, that is when the spouse can get divorced or appeal for dissolution of the marriage in the court of the law. And the Hindu Marriage Act is based on the fault theory, in which one of the aggrieved spouses, by taking the recourse of section 13 subsection 1, can approach the court of law and seek the remedy of divorce. And section 13 subsection 2 provides the grounds on which only the wife can approach the court of law and seek the remedy of divorce. Now let's discuss in brief what are the grounds of divorce as per the Hindu Marriage Act. So the first ground is adultery. So the concept of adultery may not be considered as an offense in many countries, but as per the Hindu Marriage Act, in the matrimonial offense, the adultery is considered as one of the most important grounds for seeking divorce. And adultery means the consensual and voluntary intercourse between a married person with another person, whether he or she is married or unmarried. Even the intercourse between the husband and his second wife, that is if their marriage is considered under bigamy, the person is still liable for the adultery. And the concept of adultery was inserted under the Hindu Marriage Act by the Marriage Laws Amendment Act 1976. The second ground is cruelty. So the concept of cruelty includes mental as well as physical cruelty, and the physical cruelty means when one spouse beats or causes any bodily injury to the other spouse. But the concept of mental cruelty was added, as the spouse can also be mentally tortured by the other spouse. Mental cruelty is lack of kindness which adversely affects the health of the person. It is easy to determine the nature of the physical cruelty, but difficult to say about mental cruelty. And what is basically considered as mental cruelty against husband and wife? So when the wife humiliates the husband in front of the family and friends, or when she undertakes a termination of pregnancy without the husband's consent, or she makes false allegation against him, or she denies her marital physical relationship without any valid reason, or she is having an affair, she is leading an immoral life, or she is constantly demanding for money, her behavior is very aggressive towards her husband, and she is ill-treating the husband and his family members. And what is basically considered as mental cruelty against wife by the husband? So first is like a false accusation of adultery, the demand for dowry, impotency of the husband, forcing to abort the child, problem of drunkenness of the husband, husband is having affairs, he's leading an immoral life, and he's humiliating the wife in front of the family members. Third ground is desertion. So desertion means the permanent abandonment of one spouse by the other spouse without any reasonable justification and without his consent. And in general, the rejection of the obligations of marriage by one party is considered as desertion. And there was a case Bipin Chandra Jaising Bhai versus Prabhavati, and in this case the respondent leaves the house with the intention to abandon his wife, and later on the wife approaches the court, but the defendant proved that even though he left the house with the intention to desert, but he tried to come back and he was prevented from doing so by the petitioner. So here in this case the defendant cannot be held liable for desertion. फोर्थ ग्राउंड इज कन्वर्जन. सो इफ वन ऑफ द स्पाउसेस कन्वर्ट्स हिज रिलीजन टू एनी अदर रिलीजन विदाउट द कंसेंट ऑफ द अदर स्पाउस, देन द अदर स्पाउस कैन अप्रोच द कोर्ट एंड सीक द रेमेडी ऑफ डिवोर्स. द फिफ्थ ग्राउंड इज इंसैनिटी. सो इंसैनिटी मीन्स व्हेन द पर्सन इज ऑफ अनसाउंड माइंड, एंड इंसैनिटी इज अ ग्राउंड ऑफ डिवोर्स हैज टू फॉलोइंग टू रिक्वायरमेंट्स. फर्स्ट इज रिस्पोंडेंट हैज बीन इनक्योरेबली ऑफ अनसाउंड माइंड, एंड द सेकेंड इज रिस्पोंडेंट हैज बीन सफरिंग कॉन्टिन्यूसली और इंटरमिटेंटली फ्रॉम mental disorder of such a kind and to such an extent that the petitioner cannot be reasonably expected to live with the respondent. The sixth ground is leprosy. So leprosy is an infectious disease of the skin, mucous membranes, nervous system, and this disease is transmitted from one person to another person. Thus it is considered as a valid ground for divorce. And there was a case, Swarajya Lakshmi versus G.G. Padma Rao. And in this case, the husband filed the case for granting the divorce on the ground of leprosy. And he claimed that his wife is suffering from incurable leprosy with the expert's report. Here he succeeds in getting divorce on the ground of leprosy. Another ground is venereal disease. So under this concept, if the disease is in communicable form and it can be transmitted to the other spouse, then this can be considered as a valid ground of divorce. For example, that A and B, they were married on 9th of September 2011 and later A suffered from a venereal disease and it is incurable. So there is also a chance that B can get infected by that disease if she lives with A. So here B can approach the court for dissolution of the marriage. Another ground is renunciation. So it means that when one of the spouse decides to renunciate the world and walk on the path of the God, then the other spouse can approach the court and demand the divorce. And in this concept, the party who renunciates the world is considered as a civilly dead. And it is typical Hindu practice and considered as a valid ground of divorce. And the last ground is presumption of death. So in this case, the person is presumed to have died if the family or the friends of the person does not hear any news about that person alive or dead for 7 years. And it is considered as valid ground for divorce. But the burden of proof is on the person who demands the divorce. Also, there is a provision under section 13B of the Hindu Marriage Act that the person can file petition for divorce by mutual consent of both the parties, and if the parties want to dissolve their marriage as a mutual consent, then they are required to wait for 1 year from the date of the marriage, and they have to show that they are living separately for one or more year and not able to live with one another. As per section 14 of the Hindu Marriage Act, no court will entertain the petition of divorce within 1 year of the marriage, but can be entertained if the matter is related to bigamy and where the consent of the spouse was taken through misrepresentation, fraud and undue influence. And the section 15 of this act provides that the marriage can get dissolved and no further petition was filed by any of the spouses against the order of the court, and the time for the appeal has already been expired. So at that time it is assumed that both the spouses are satisfied, and then only the divorced person can remarry. So what we can conclude from this entire concept is that the Hindu Marriage Act 1955 provides various provisions regarding divorce, and the Hindu Marriage Act defines divorce as a dissolution of marriage. The main three theories related to divorce are fault theory, mutual consent, and irretrievable theory. And in India, the fault theory works in the matter of the divorce, and under this theory, marriage can be ended when one of the spouses is responsible for the offense under matrimonial offenses. The innocent spouse can here seek the remedy of divorce, and under the Hindu Marriage Act, the basic grounds on which the Hindu women can seek the remedy of divorce are adultery, desertion, leprosy, cruelty, conversion, venereal disease, and all the grounds that we have discussed in this particular video. But many philosophers still criticize the concept of divorce, and the Hindu married women can also apply for the maintenance under section 125 of the CRPC, and so the spouse who is innocent can approach the court and can seek the remedy of divorce. So guys, that's all about my discussion on this entire concept. I hope you all like my video. If you guys have any doubt with regard to this video, then you can comment in the comment section. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel Lex Click. We will meet in the next video. Till then, bye.